Morning, everybody. My name is Abe Davis. I'm the operations chief with the Alaska Green Incident Management Team. And this is your Tuesday, July 5th operational update for the Lyme complex. So yesterday was, in general, was kind of moderated conditions across the fire complex. We did have overcast skies for most of the day, really in and out of periods of opportunities to fly, pretty poor smoky visibility up north. Did have a little bit of clearing down on the south end of the fire, and that allowed folks to kind of get up and take a look at some things. We've got crews engaged down on the south end of the fire, doing some mop up along, we've got three different allotments we're working on right now, and they're also looking at other allotments within the fire's footprints that we need to get into in the coming days, and coming up with a good game plan of just how much work we've got ahead of us down there. We did see a little bit of increased activity down on the very south portion of the fire this yesterday evening, but otherwise things are looking pretty good down on that fire. As we come back up to the north here, we'll zoom back out and go up towards Lyme Village. So night before last, crews started burning out around. If we can zoom in on Lyme Village here, we can kind of focus in. We'll come in just a little bit more. Crews started burning along this indirect line outside of Lyme Village. They burned late into the evening, and then they kind of lost their burn window due to higher increased relative humidities and just the amount of smoke and overcast in there. The fuels just got shaded out and was very receptive. So they did try again yesterday to pick that operation up and complete it, and we just didn't have the fuel conditions to be able to complete that operation. So today, crews are going to be seeing what kind of opportunities we can have in there to continue that operation. We do have some rain and showers in the forecast that would certainly delay our operations there. If we zoom back out, additionally, we're assessing a lot of these blocks that you can see. These are all native allotments out there. We're assessing those, keeping track of where the fire's at, and making sure we've got plans in place to protect those and keep fire off of those values as these fires continue to grow. Elsewhere on the complex, yesterday we were able to do a little bit of flying. In the afternoon, we were able to get folks up to some of the sites we've previously done protection on. We've inserted folks up into the little Switzerland cabin site, which we've been referring to, up to the north and west of Fire 228. We were able to check on that and get some equipment pulled out of there. And also just going back and visiting some of the other sites that we haven't been able to get back into in the last few days with the poor visibility. So all in all, things across the complex yesterday were, we did see reduced fire activity. We expect to continue to see that with the moisture that's gonna be coming into the area in a couple of days. We expect chances of rain and showers to increase as we go into tomorrow and Thursday, and that's certainly gonna have an impact. But the one thing that everybody's keeping in mind is the fuels are extremely dry, and it won't take long for those, depending on how much rain we get, for them to dry back out and us to kind of have to resume operations out there. So we're keeping that in mind as we come into this little bit of a wedding event. With that, we'll talk to you all again tomorrow. Have a good day.